Today we are going to discuss poultry diseases part 2. As we have already discussed, the poultry industry is an economic industry for the small scale industry and the medium large scale industries. So if these poultry birds are being attacked with diseases, it leads to a huge loss to the poultry farmer or the industry. So economic loss is there. To protect these birds from the diseases, we have to learn what are the diseases that are being caused to the poultry industries. As we have already discussed, poultry industry is facing diseases with infectious agents and non-infectious agents. Infectious agents are virus, bacteria, protozoonal disease, fungal diseases, and other nutritional deficiency diseases, and environmental diseases due to high temperature, relative humidity, etc. And now we are going to see the viral diseases caused by the infectious agents. The viral diseases are many types in the poultry industry. The first one, Brachyury disease or Newcastle disease, Marks disease, Gumboro disease, which is caused to the bursal. So it is known as infectious bursal disease. Infectious bronchitis as in humans, infectious laryngotracheitis, ILT, fowl pox, that is the cholera, avian encephalomyelitis, lymphoid leukosis, inclusion body hepatitis, infectious viral arthritis. These diseases are seen in the birds caused due to the infectious agents, the viral diseases. Egg drop syndrome. Now coming to the Brachyury disease or the Newcastle disease. It is also known as RD. It is a highly contagious disease caused by an Evula virus, in which the usual form is a respiratory condition. But other main clinical signs may include nervous manifestations, depression, dropping wings, twisted head or paralysis, diarrhea, and swelling of eyes and the neck. These are the symptoms that are being observed in the birds. The pathology is known as Brachyury disease in India shows diphtheritic hemorrhagic lesions of the alimentary tract, mainly in cecae and cloaca. In its viscerotrophic presentation, it is also common to find edema or petechia in the gizzard and hemorrhagic ovaries. So all the organs are affected by this viral infection. Its importance lies in the mortality and the low productivity yield an outbreak could cause, since it may lead to a partial or total stop in egg production and rough or thin eggshells. So here heavy loss, as the bird is almost in a death stage, and also the egg producing, the meat producing animals cannot produce a meat properly. That is, the bird cannot develop properly, and here the eggshells, the egg layers, they cannot produce the proper egg production, that is having rough or thin eggshells, which are not useful for transport or for the sale. Now you can see in this diagram the hens that are showing the, you will see with the laser pointer, here it is having the dullness due to this Ranicate disease, and here twisted or the paralytic condition of the bird you can see, and here total the chicks, they are also affected, and here the birds are totally with very pathetic condition. Now here the comb also, cyanosis of the comb also, you can see the darkness of the comb itself indicates the presence of the virus. Next, Marks disease. It is also known as MD disease. Marks disease is a neoplastic disease caused by an oncogenic herpes virus. The virus infects lymphocyte cells that is sometime, some cases will become tumor cells and infiltrated in different organs and tissue of the animal. Symptomatology depends on the location of the tumor. There are three types of presentations of the disease: cutaneous, nervous, or visceral. That means it may attack the skin, nervous system, or the visceral organs. The cutaneous, that is in the skin, appearance of the nodules at the level of follicles of the feathers. The in visceral, nodular lesions will be caused, and the general disorder causes general disorder and death of the animal. Nervous, in nervous tissues, paralysis of the legs due to unilateral affection of the sciatic nerve, or blindness due to the effect of infiltration of the nerves. Here the birds, they are drastically affected by the Marks disease and cause a huge loss to the poultry industry. Once they are attacked, the contamination spreads and all the birds may die within a very short period. This attacks the skin or the cutaneous, nervous system, and the visceral organs. If it attacks the cutaneous system, the nodules at the level of the follicles of the feather, and visceral organs have the nodular lesions are present, which causes death to the animal. And in nervous system, it shows the paralysis effect. In the legs, the sciatic nerve is affected, or blindness due to the effect of infiltration of the nerves. Now here we can see the muscular hemorrhage in the muscles, four limbs or the hind limbs. And here you can see the paralysis of the legs. Here also the paralysis, the bird is paralyzed and it cannot stand on its own. And here the eyes, see, this is the clear vision where it can see. But due to this Marks disease, the blindness, eye blindness, and here lymphomatous, this is the normal condition, and where with the neural lymphomatous, the constriction has taken place. Avian encephalomyelitis. It is also known as AE disease. It is a viral infection of central nervous system of the poultry. Primarily chicks, turkeys, Japanese quails, and peahens are being affected by these avian encephalomyelitis. It is found worldwide and is characterized by ataxia, loss of muscle coordination, and tremors, especially of the head and neck, and a drop in egg production and hatchability in hens. See, here this avian encephalomyelitis affects the central nervous system, and the bird loses muscle coordination, tremors may occur, head and neck, and dropping of the egg production in case of the layers. Mortality rate from these disease can be high. AE causes caused by a picorna virus. It is caused by avian encephalomyelitis, is caused by picanovirus. Virus present in droppings may survive for more than 4 weeks. There is no treatment for avian encephalomyelitis. Only vaccination at the earlier stages can protect the birds. After affected birds should be killed and incinerated. Egg drop syndrome. Egg drop syndrome, EDS, is caused by a viral infection in laying hens. It is characterized by production of soft-shelled and shell-less eggs in apparently healthy birds and leads to a sudden drop 10 to 40% in recorded egg production or a failure to achieve a normal peak in production. Now, this is a great loss to the layer farmers. Poultry farmer, where a drop down of 10 to 40%, that means the 10 to 40%, if his investment on his investment and also the food that is being given, the investment on the food, water, shelter and everything is being gone to that farmer. A total loss will be at a peak stage in the production of the eggs also. The eggshells are not produced properly, with a less, the shell is dropped out, the thickening of calcium carbonate is not being developed due to the egg drop syndrome, that is the viral that is present in the body. EDS is caused by infection with the egg drop syndrome virus, which is an adenovirus. The incubation period is 3 to 5 days and the course of disease is 4 to 10 weeks. 4 to 10 weeks, the incubation period of the virus is 5 days and the course of the disease is 4 to 10 weeks. There is no successful treatment for egg drop syndrome. The prevention of horizontal spread relies on good biosecurity and washing and disinfecting plastic egg trays. The disinfection is only the best method to reduce or minimize the egg drop disease. Now we can see here the eggs. Here the eggshell is not properly built and here the egg shape is different, elongated, and here the breakage in the cell, eggshell, here also not properly built up. You can see all the foldings of the skin, outer layer of the shell, different types of formations of the shells we can observe. That means here we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 eggs are spoiled. That means like this n number of eggs, that is 10 to 40% of loss leads to the high economic loss to the poultry farmer who is having the layers industry. Infectious. Next is the infectious laryngotracheitis, which affects the, this virus affects the larynx and the trachea of the birds. It is a respiratory disease caused by herpes virus that could appear in different ways: pre-acute, subacute or chronic stages. It is in three stages: pre-acute or subacute or chronic stage. It is caused by herpes virus. Due to these, clinical signs vary from a extreme severity with deaths of asphyxia to a very mild symptomology that is not possible to differentiate from other respiratory diseases. This infectious laryngotracheitis cannot be differentiated from other respiratory diseases. This virus causes fibrinous and hemorrhagic infiltrations of the respiratory tract. Here, due to this laryngotracheitis infection, which causes fibrinous and hemorrhagic infiltrations in the respiratory tract. So, the presence of blood in the trachea, sinus and oral cavity makes breathing difficulty. Due to the presence of blood in trachea, sinus and oral cavity makes breathing difficult. That's why the birds cannot breathe properly. In the postmortem examination, fibrinous necrotic caseous and diphtheritic plaques and plugs are found in the trachea, larynx and mouth. When they are postmortem, they found in trachea, larynx and mouth fibrinous necrotic caseous plugs, diphtheric plague is seen in the trachea, larynx and mouth. Next, coming to the Gumboro disease, IBD, infectious, it is also known as infectious bursa disease. The IBD is an acute viral infection caused by Byrnavirus. As one of its name indicates, it mainly affects bursa of Fabricius, destroying the immature B lymphocytes of the young animals. That means it affects the immunity of the bird. It attacks the B lymphocytes in the young birds. Now here growers are affected by this disease. If growers are affected, then automatically the poultry industry is being affected, because the growers are affected and the chicks cannot develop. Hence, the adult birds are not produced in the required amounts. That is, again, leads to the high production deficiency. Clinically, it is observed in chicks between 3rd to 6 week old. In cases showing clinical signs of diseases, diffuse hemorrhagic lesions are often observed in pectoral muscles and thighs. This also can be seen in pectoral muscles and thigh. And some diffuse hemorrhagic lesions are also observed in pectoral muscles and thighs. In cases showing clinical signs of the disease, diffuse hemorrhagic is observed in pectoral muscles and thighs. Now here you can see the Gumboro disease. This is a normal bursa fabricus, but the infected bursa fabricus has been changed into dark color. And here this is the dissected bird. You can see here the dark color. The bursa is totally been damaged in the bird. Infectious bronchitis, IB disease. This viral disease, exclusive of chicks, that is the growers, is confined to the respiratory system and urinogenital tracts. They are different strains of virus with greater or lesser affinity for the system named before. So this is the totally, it affects the growers, the chicks, respiratory system and urinogenital tract, which is being affected by infectious bronchitis viral infection. This virus has high mutagenic capacity, hence the main difficulty to fight against it, because vaccination does not guarantee to be resistant to the disease. Most visible signs are those of upper respiratory tract, that is sneezing and nasal discharge, where Whenever these chicks or the growers are affected with infectious bronchitis, the upper respiratory tract is infected and sneezing and nasal discharge is being released. So these chicks, they discharge their nasal discharges in the litter. So when the birds are moving around, then the contamination spreads through their air. The lesions caused by this disease are serous, hemorrhagic, catarrhal or caseous, exudate in trachea, pneumonia or opaque air sacs with possible caseous material, atrophied ovary and inflamed oviduct and interstitial nephritis, which leads kidneys are enlarged and pale. Here the birds, they suffer a lot with this infectious bronchitis disease that is caused by the virus, pneumonia, and ovaries are infected, intestinal nephritis, kidneys are enlarged and they are pale in color. Now here we can see the hemorrhagic exudes. Here this you can see here, and atrophied oviducts. See here, the oviduct is also yellow in color. Misshapen follicles, you can see here, the green color, and the yellow color shows the autophiled oviducts, pale and swollen kidney. Here you can see the kidneys are infected. For small birds or the growers' chicks, they are highly affected and they are sufferers. Next, infectious coryza or IC disease. Infectious coryza is a highly contagious bacterial disease produced by AV bacterium paragalinarium. It shows mainly rhinitis and infraorbital sinusitis, seen as a facial edema in the area. Facial edema is seen in these chicks where they are contaminated with infectious coryza. Conjunctivitis and abundant nasal and ocular secretions that may cause eyelids adherence could also appear. Conjunctivitis, you can see abundant nasal secretions that may cause eyelids adherence could also appear. Usually this state is accompanied by decreased consumption of food because the eyes are closed. It cannot see, it cannot eat or drink the water, and in laying birds by variable reduction of egg production. Not only the chicks or the growers, but the adult birds, that is the layers, are also affected in the reduction of the egg production. Lower respiratory tract infection rarely occurs. Now here you can see the infectious in coryza. The eyelids are closed. Here you can easily spot out, and the nasal region is also been affected lesions. See, total eye swelling you can see. These are the swellings. Due to this, the bird cannot eat properly or drink the water properly, whereas the layers cannot produce the eggs. Chronic respiratory diseases, CRD. It is contagious disease, with a slow development and prolonged course, caused by the bacterium Mycoplasma species, affects the respiratory system, sneezing, nasal discharge. Broilers' mortality rate may be low in case without complications, but could reach 30% in case complicated with other bacteria and viruses. There are also collateral loss due to stunted growth and sacrifice before reaching the terms. Mortality can be low in layers, however, it causes a drop in the egg laying rate. Lesions that appear are very variable depending on whether they are other contaminant infection or not, and on the mycoplasm agent itself. Here, the egg laying rate is decreased and mortality is to some extent lower. Sinusitis, tracheitis, air sacculitis, thickening and turbidity of the alveoli, exudative accumulation, fibrinopleurent, pericarditis and perihepatitis could be observed. Now here you can see the chronic respiratory diseases. Here this area is being affected. Heart is being affected, liver is being affected, proventriculus, gizzard, liver, all the organs are affected and leads to the less production of the eggs. Fowl cholera or avian cholera. It is a contagious bacterial disease caused by Pasteurella, Multocodia, which affects adult birds or birds in the period of sexual development, that consists of three clinical presentations: pre-acute forms, and post-acute forms. The development of sudden death without previous symptoms. It is not frequent nowadays due to immunization of the breeds. It leads to pre-acute forms. In the acute forms, it has course of 1 to 2 days, whether the birds show anorexia, fever, depression, profuse white or grayish diarrhea, respiratory difficulty with abundant mucus and cyanosis visible on crest and wattles. Chronic forms. Animals remain sick and chaotic for a long time with pleurent or caseous inflammations of the wattle and possible subcutaneous abscess. Outbreak of occur during low temperature and high humidity, late summers, autumn and winter. That means the temperature and humidity plays a vital role to control the diseases. Necrophysis. Feeding findings seen in an acute outbreak lesions look like hemorrhagic septicemia with pectia and generalized hemorrhages in organs and skin. Conjunctive spleen without splenomegaly, Miller necrosis in the liver and edematous lungs, sometimes with small pleurent grayish area. Caseous masses may appear in the air sacs and in the peritoneum in chronic presentations. Fowl cholera, you can see the lungs are being affected. You can see all the dots, small dots are being observed. Fowl pox or avian pox. It is a moderate viral disease with a slow development caused by pox virus. This virus induces a rapid growth of superficial layer in the skin and mucous membrane that forms masses of proliferative tissue. This virus induces a rapid growth of superficial layers in the skin and mucous membrane that forms masses of proliferative tissue. The disease has two presentations depending upon the location: cutaneous or dry form on the skin without feathers or diptheric or wet forms in the alimentary and upper respiratory tract. Both could evolve alone or simultaneously. That means it can be affected in both ways, cutaneous form or the mucous membranes, that is the respiratory tract. Diphtheria injuries are more serious as they cause death and suffocation or starvation. The second one, mucous membrane infections, which causes serious injuries that leads to death and suffocation or starvation. Lesions vary according to the stage of development. Papillae, vessels, pustules or crusts, mainly in regions of head. Diphtheric lesions are yellowish or whitish plaques that grow on the mucous shells of the nasal and buccal cavities, sinuses, larynx, pharynx, trachea or esophagus. Now here you can see the vessels on the bird. Here you can see small white patches, white plaques. You can observe here, and also the pustules around the eye, all the skin, the foldings of the, and here this bird is suffering from yellow plaques on mucous membranes in the mouth, esophagus and upper respiratory tract. It is unable to breathe, so it has opened its mouth. Now here, what to do if your birds look sick? The very important thing is to have a very thorough check daily. The poultry farmer or the labor, that is the laborers who are inside the farm, have to observe the birds very, very consciously, and they have to pick the sick birds, isolate the sick birds immediately, dispose of dead birds prominently and properly, burning or burrowing they have to do, observe the rest of the flock for signs and disease, and proper cleaning of the litter is also plays a vital role in controlling the diseases. Call the veterinarian doctor, animal health technician or extension agent for the advice and assistance. Do not move birds or eggs off from the farm. Do not add new birds to the flock. Do not visit other farms, because the persons who are working in the infected poultry farms, if they go to a new farm, they will contaminate. They are the carriers. They contaminate the other farm and it leads to the loss of that farm also. New birds should not be added to the infected cages or the folks, because the infection can be spread to the new birds. And here, do not move the birds or eggs off your farm. These eggs have to be removed. The contaminated eggs have to be removed properly, incinerate or burn them. All the birds and all the litter, everything has to be cleaned and disinfected. Thank you. Now we can see the next bacterial diseases in part 3, continuation of part 3.